Off to a cracking start. Nick's just fucked his bottle cage.
Crash out.
Bye.
See ya.
I'll miss you.
Bye.
Bye.
But look at these cracking views, hey.
Well, we're doing a bike packing trip. Just decided, you know, and stuff it, like, just sick of our everyday lives right now. Sick of work, I'm sick of uni. So we just thought we'd pack up, shift off and go for 4 days, 3 or 4 days, depending on how cracked we are at one point. Just see what happens, just explore the state, see how far we can go in as little time as possible.
Distinctly remember this bottle being leak-proof was one of its features.
Yeah.
BPA free.
Look, this is full and I haven't drank any.
So it's not at the bottom.
That's the offending split. But so it's splashed out. Here, there's some stage lighting again.
That's not the worst thing in
it's
the world.
Splashed out.
At least you can carry some water.
Yeah. I might go for a big, like, 1.5 litre Mount Franklin bottle or something.
So yeah.
Just in this.
We've arrived.
Day
destination.
One,
night one. What do you reckon?
Whoa, a bit sore now. Good day. A little park up. Ready for tomorrow.
So, your chief fire lighter.
Chief.
I'm a tent setter up, right?
I'm Chief Ooga Dooga, caveman fire lighter.
So here we are, night one park up. We're in the Brisbane Ranges. So it was just over 100k tonight. Yeah, it was good fun. We were hooking along towards the end, just both put a podcast in. So now we've got a tent set up somewhere over there. We got our fire going and we're just cooking up our dinner. Bedtime night one. Here we are. All tucked in. Day two, well, really day one. Yesterday was just an afternoon, but we on skis.
On the road.
Peak down, always. I'm a changed man, I used to be peak up. There we go. 45 minutes into our ride this morning, and it's time, we're at the Lethbridge General Store. time to park up here, cook some porridge, and get some supplies at the store. Nick's full cracked already. Got a sandwich and a sausage roll. That's what someone who's cracked would say.
Oh.
And a coffee. Bloody. Oh, here we go. This is the Newey. Beautiful. I guess it is the red ambulance. Really got me out of trouble. Had a bit of a pickle.
Bit of fish in Apollo Bay, because it'd be rude not to, huh?
So hungry, can't wait.
We've just turned onto our first gated road of the trip. This is very exciting.
Caught out by some sticks.
Man down. Fuck. This is absolute slop, isn't it? We've got to make it to Capot Lighthouse before sunset.
Yeah.
So, we soldier on.
Doesn't look good.
There we go.
Nope. As you can see, I've done a good number on myself.
Oh, my.
Sorry, it's bouncy. We're back on a gravel road, even though it's corrugated to the shithouse. I could just about kiss it.
we're so close. So Cape Otway Lighthouse is just down here.
So just got to Cape Otway Lighthouse, and as you can see, it's closed. Disappointment City. I think Dylan's trying to get the drone up right now.
And it does set over the water as well.
Jeez, that's sensational.
We're just having a look at the elevation from today, from where we've climbed, where we're yet to climb. So about, what are we, just over 30 k's away from our campsite. We got to Cape Otway Lighthouse, and who would have guessed it, the lighthouse is closed. So
we're just having a bit of a spirit boosting hot chock before pushing onto our campsite.
We've had a bit of a change of plans tonight. From Cape Otway Lighthouse, we've decided to head up the Great Ocean Road towards the 12 Apostles rather than heading back inland, which was what we... So, pretty much, that'll make tonight longer, but shorten tomorrow a bit. So we just went the wrong way. This is now where we go, and that is our path. So parked up in Labor's Hill, I think it's called. It's like bugger all here. But we're gonna cook some food.
So we've made a call to push on through the night. Potentially not all night, but we're gonna, yeah, push on, give it a crack, and basically see how we go.
Respect that vibration for the better, of course. Teleport the whole planet here through music.
This is a bit grim. After getting here, over here is Simpson at 2:20 a.m. It's now 7 a.m. And my throat is so sore. Yep.
Porridge, coffee, Nick's coffee. Nick. My Crocs.
Fuck, that got rough yesterday, didn't it? Bloody terrible. Towards the end, it was getting pretty solid. I was in a bit of a zone at the end, just with a bit of rice up me and some fluids and some coffee. But yeah, I had to pull a pin. So we made some head ground into today, though. We've only got 200Ks until Halls Gap instead of 300. So, but it's starting to get pretty real. The body's getting pretty sore. Sleeping on the ground's not that great for 5 hours.
No, actually feeling pretty sick, unfortunately. I texted Nick the night of the day before we left. The night before we left, I guess. And I said my throat's like razor blades. And it's come pretty good the last couple of days. And then last night, it's like razor blades again. And my nose is runny. So that's not ideal. But overall, like, my legs feel fine. I'm cramping really bad, like, in my traps. When I was, like, doing anything other than being in the tri bars, just, like, sitting there. Right. Today, what I'm looking forward to is whatever we can get at a servo. I'm just going to get it up me.
Day 3, we're all packed up and ready to go. Simpson to Halls Gap, with a truck stop definitely on the way for a greasy feed, potentially a shower, but I reckon probably wait to Halls Gap for that.
The only time ever it's acceptable to eat Sour Patch Kids at 9:30 in the morning.
We've just made a booking in Dunkeld at a pub for some food. Pretty stuffed, to be honest. We've just got to Dunkeld. We're gonna have dinner here at the pub, and then we've got to push on another 60Ks or so to Halls Gap, which is where we got accommodation. And there's no dress code at the pub, but we imagine there's a stink code, so that should do the trick.
Good food.
Nick's buckled. Nah, he's coming good.
Ooh, let's figure this out. Yeah, the snot out of the mustache. We've had dinner. We're back on the road again.
and trucking to Hall's Gap. That's the first, oh man, last night was so wet and cold that the night shift was really grim. But now, because we've just sat in a warm restaurant, all our like base layers have dried out, and it's actually really pleasant. So this should be fun, I reckon. I'm just saying it's nice and warm that we're dry.
It's actually so good. It's turned out to an unreal night. Plus we've had a mean pub feed. I'm not hunger flattened, starving, and want to die anymore. So that's the next link.
This is really beautiful. We've just stopped and turned our lights off. You cannot pick it up on the iPhone camera at all, but we can see the stars. Big silhouette of one of the mountains in front of us. I don't know what it's called.
Here we are, just rolling into the main drag of Hall's Gap. Unfortunately, it looks like the servo here is closed because I could go for a feed again. But we've made it, which means we get to shower and have a comfortable bed. So that's the main thing. And we've already seen the famous kangaroos wandering around the main drag too, which is a bit exciting. We've made it to our room. I think we got the honeymoon suite because we just got a random hot tub in the room. That's a bit interesting. We won't be using that one. And my voice is starting to go, so I think I need a good sleep. I kind of imagine this is what it feels like to be Bear Grylls. Like, you just go out, pretend to be doing epic stuff all day, and then come back to your nice hotel room, watch a bit of TV, park up in a comfy bed, and have a good night's sleep.
Best sleep I've ever had in my life. Get the worst. Everything's starting to get real sore now. Legs, most of my body, so I don't know about Dylan. Gonna go check out the Barocca lookout now, just see what happens, and then check the view, and then get shifting, get moving.
Come back for a cafe, you reckon? Or...
Yeah, gotta get some brekkie uppers.
Final day. I'm feeling a bit worse for wear. I've got a sore throat, and blocked nose, and runny nose, and the works, but. Yeah, I'm just looking forward to, actually really looking forward to getting up to this lookout, and then really looking forward to plugging on home as well.
My ass hurts, my loose tendons hurt, both of them, patel tendons. My neck's pretty crooked.
It turns out to get to the lookout we want to go to, there's steps involved. So off with the Bonts, on with the Crocs. We're going for a hike.
Ye old faithful.
Okay, this sucks a bit now. This is our view from the lookout that we just hiked up for. And it's raining. And the 3.5K hike took us an hour. So, just making some brekkie. And I think we're either gonna pay the trees over there to take us down, or we're just gonna try and hitchhike or something, but that's the view. Since we've burnt 3 hours of our day,
We're considering staying another night in Halls Gap.
We're on our way back down. No one wanted to give us a lift back.
That was rude.
Hello fans.
Quick update. We've come back down from the top of the viewing thing, whatever it was.
Barocca lookout.
Barocca. And it's a lot warmer and drier down here, and we decided staying another night is a bit soft and unnecessary. So we're gonna having a bit of lunch. We're gonna have a bit more lunch.
Nice donut, mate.
At the bakery or something. And then hit the road. So it's 180 Ks back home. Gonna be pulling another night shift. But I think it's gonna beat staying around another night and then trying to do it tomorrow.
Yeah, so we've left Halls Gap, gone through Stall, on our way to Maryborough now.
So, moral of the story, we're a long way in, a fourth night shift in a row. There's going to be a long night shift as well. And I'm looking forward to the Golden Arches. Leaving the Golden Arches now, and of course it's freezing cold, so Nick's getting a bit more warm gear out and we'll be good to push home. We're in Newstead now though, which is good, so 15 k's from home, back on familiar territory, but I don't know if knowing the roads is going to make it easier or harder, because you know what's coming up. Feeling good, considering, but definitely ready to park up the bike for a day or two.
Epic trip. How good.
Done.
Back home.
How good was that?
That's a wrap on the trip. What do you reckon?
Pretty done. So much fun.
Cheers for watching, viewers. Sayonara.